Feminist Creativus presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I still find you well, my dear friends. And for this morning, we want to consider the art of negotiation as we find God and Moses in conversation. Come with me to the book of Numbers. We are reading at chapter 14 and we continue from verse 13. It reads as follows in the Holman Bible. But Moses replied to the Lord, "The Egyptians will hear about it, for by your strength you brought up these people from them. They will tell it to the inhabitants of this land. They have heard that you, Lord, are among these people. How you, Lord, are seen face to face, how your cloud stands over them, and how you go before them in a pillar of cloud by day and in a pillar of fire by night. If you kill these people with a single blow, the nations that have heard of your fame will declare, 'Since the Lord was unable to bring these people into the land that he sought to give them, he has slaughtered them in the wilderness.' So now, may my Lord's power be magnified, just as you have spoken. The Lord is slow to anger and rich in faithful love, forgiving wrongdoing and rebellion. But he will not leave the guilty unpunished, bringing the consequences of the father's wrongdoing on the children to the third and fourth generation. Please pardon the wrongdoing of these people in keeping with the greatness of your faithful love, just as you have forgiven them from Egypt until now." The Lord responded, "I have pardoned them as you requested." May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as he pardons us this very morning. Let us pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of calling upon your name. Early in the morning, we seek to be pardoned of our sins of commission and the sins of omission. Dear Father, may we receive mercy from up on high. We do not deserve it. But because you love us and you are faithful unto us, treat us, dear Lord, through the name and worthy blood of Jesus Christ that covers us. May we become worthy of that kingdom to come. This has been our prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, amen and amen. My dear friends, just allow me for today to raise 7 points on the art of negotiation, or the 7 rules of negotiation, or the 7 principles of negotiation. Here is rule or principle number 1. It goes as follows. Do not make the negotiation about you. Moses is in negotiation with God, and God has just said to Moses, "I am going to give you an opportunity to become a greater nation than these people who are ungrateful." But notice, as Moses now corresponds and talks to God from verse 18 to verse 20, at no point does he talk about himself. As you go to a negotiating table, appreciate this. The fact that you are already on the table, if you are at the table, it means your credentials have been established. It means he or she who you are negotiating with has already given you a chance and is paying attention to you. Going on to establish your credentials is to go on an overkill. Do not make it about you. No one at a negotiation table wishes to spend time listening to you talking about yourself. Rule number 2, speak to the mission. Moses says to God, "Remember, we have the children of Egypt, the ones whom I went over and told, 'The Lord has said, let my people go so they can worship me in the wilderness.' We told them the greater mission is we need to deliver these people from Egypt and deliver them to Canaan. They must reach the promised land. Let us speak to the mission." As we go to a negotiating table where things have gone out of place, things are helter-skelter, things are upside down, it's topsy-turvy, we want to take time to talk to the mission. Do not spend time talking about what has gone wrong. View the bigger picture and keep your lenses focused on that. Rule number 3, bring the other party into the mix. without being accusatory. This is a very thin line to balance. You need to make sure you find that sweet spot. Moses says to God, God, you are among these people. God, the cloud is seen by day, the pillar of fire by night. Your face is seen face to face right here in this camp. When you deal with these people and you just expunge them, you obliterate them in one blow, how are these people going to perceive you? Now, what Moses is saying is not necessarily that God, you have been watching as things were going out of hand, but he's simply saying, God, you have been close to these people. You are a part of them and they belong to you. In so doing, Moses is managing to bring God into the problem space, into the sphere where there is an issue that needs to be resolved, so that God does not remain an outsider, an aloof bystander. This is an art that as we negotiate during the week, I would say, consider it as rule number three. How can you bring the other party close to the problem without accusing them? Find that sweet spot. Number four, speak to the protection of the other's reputation. Now God is being told by Moses, the Egyptians are going to tell these nations, and these nations are then going to say about you that God failed to bring them into the promised land. Consequently, what did he do? He killed them all in the desert. Speak to the reputation of the person you are negotiating with. Make them appreciate that there are issues that are beyond their control. God can control the behavior of the Egyptians, but can he control the behavior of the other nations who are yet to come into a relationship with him, who are yet to appreciate who he is and what he has been doing all along? So as we go into these negotiations, you would want to make this apparent. There are conditions that you cannot control beyond this decision, beyond what has happened. Think about those and say to yourself, how am I going to make peace with the outcome, the domino effect? For there is a ripple effect that always comes from going into decision making. Number five, I love this one. Speak to the other person's arsenal and show them the options that they have. The children of Israel have already messed up. God is saying, I'm going to punish these people. I'm going to strike them with a plague, just one plague, and they'll be done and finished. But Moses now turns and he says, God, are you aware that besides punishment, you also have the option of loving them? You have the option of forgiving them. Speak to the options. What do they have in their hands? So as we negotiate, take time to show those that you're negotiating with that in spite of breaking everything apart, they also have an option to exercise some other leeway of reaching a better conclusion. Now, I love the last bit. The last bit is the appeal. Moses splits his appeal into two points. At rule number six, Moses then says, please pardon these people for their wrongdoing. These people are to be pardoned for their wrongdoing. As he makes his appeal, notice he only gets to mention the problem at item number six, at rule number six, further down the line. Why further down the line? You do not want to make the mistake of not acknowledging that there is a problem. Moses makes sure that he acknowledges things have not gone right. You do not want to go to a negotiating table and refuse. That is a sign of pride. That is a sign of insensitivity. Someone has been wronged. At least appreciate that God has been wronged. And he says, please, Lord, pardon them for their wrongdoing. Place the acknowledgement at the tail end along with the plea. Place it at the tail end along with the plea and make sure you mention it. Point number seven, which is our rule number seven as we come to an end. Show that you are not making a difficult or strange proposition. Moses says to God, you have been forgiving them since they left Egypt. I'm not asking you something you have not done. I am not asking you to do something out of the ordinary. I'm simply asking you to be yourself. I'm simply asking you to continue to be the merciful God that we have known you to be. Having gone through these seven steps, what does God say at verse number 20? Read it with me. The Lord responded, I have pardoned them as you requested. May the Lord pardon you and I. May this be our request this morning, Dear Lord, we have done wrong by you, and we negotiate for a second chance. Show us mercy, O Lord. Until you meet again on Friday, blessings and peace.